What's up, y'all? How you feeling this afternoon or this morning? What country you are or at? This is Smokey Black, 19750. It's here. 922 is here, y'all. But there's a catch. This is the early access version. So I can still play online, but as far as like the other players, if you didn't pre-order the game, you can't get it until the release date. Only thing I'm doing right now is doing the early accesses. Let me get this started real quick. Hold on real quick. Only way you can play the game early is if you release the game early and pre-order. It's the only way you're gonna play it. I just so happened to pre-order the game. But let me tell you what I'm working with for right now. I really don't have no roster for real. But I did play the game a little bit. I got 56 packs. But right now, what I'm doing missions and stuff. Now, this is what it's looking like now. I mean, this is totally different compared to what 21 was, y'all. Now, this is my team right now so far. I don't even have a team for real. But I did win Lamar Jackson, you feel me? I won a couple of silvers. My team is like complete trash right now. But I did pick a playbook, the Gold Giants playbook. I wonder. Can't do it yet. I don't think we can possibly do that again this year. But if you want to get the best cards, you have to see what's up in the auction block to see what's going on. Let's see what they got out here. Now, mind you, this is the early access, so they look cheap right now, but you know, once things really start getting cooking, then yeah, as you can see, it's no 96, 97s, it's no 95s, as I see, it's a few glitches on this game. Any 90s, it's nothing. It's really nothing in the auction block right now. Okay. Now, these are cheaper right now, y'all. Now, mind you, this stuff is cheap because this is early access. Now, when the games start opening up, they're going to start taxing. As you can see, they got Devontae Adams, Patrick Mahomes, Travis Kelce. That's all you really see for real. Jalen Ramsey, you see how I'm saying? See how the coin selections are going up? Now, I wouldn't mind looking for Derrick Henry because he just rolled everybody over. I feel they got Aaron Donald. That's all they really got. Really. But let's get this gameplay started with the early access. I see somebody bought Travis Kelce already. They trying to make them coins quick. But we ain't really doing much. Only thing we doing right now, we're going to be doing missions right now. Let's see what they got. I'm going to do the ultimate season. See what they got. Got four activities. I can play head to head.
Challenge of the first quarter with less than 2 minutes left on the clock. You're ahead by four. You've got possession in your own territory. Third and long. He's going to fire one deep, middle of the field. Got a man.
Men have become famous.
By That's what I'm talking about.
Times and years on BigFollowers.com.
Tom Brady with two first quarter touchdown passes. And just like that, another ultimate challenge has been defeated. Savor the victory if only.
Men have become famous. By followers, primes, and viewers on BigFollowers.com.
The coach here, and welcome to this ultimate challenge. Sit back and relax. You're in for a real treat with this matchup.
Strapped in, it's just about time to get the party started. And we are underway from the Superdome. On the return, Deontay Harris. And he will quite make it to the 25. Winston and the Saints now with a first and 10 at their own 24. They'll run it for the first time with Alvin Kamara. And able to use his stiff arm for a little bit of leverage before he's taken down. A pretty good game. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
And Winston.
Get about, dog.
And it's picked up by the Buccaneers.
No. I need a touchdown.
It's down inside the 10 to the 8-yard line. Every week we hear talk about create turnovers. yards, create turnovers. In particular, they wanted to force some fumbles. They got one right there.
And it shows you how the game has changed.
And in for the Buccaneers, touchdown. From 8 yards out, and the Bucs have taken a first quarter lead.
We're still in the first quarter, but it's apparent they're going to have to come up with a different defensive game plan for him, because right now he's kind of having his way against that defense and has added a touchdown to the list. How do you slow him down? They're going to have to mix up some coverages, maybe change who's guarding him.
Point after here coming up. And that gives the Bucs a 7-0 lead.
When I played this game yesterday with Patrick Mahomes, he has no poise. Tom Brady has poise. On this particular version of Tom Brady.
Saints, they get ready to set up shop for their second drive. And last time, not only the turnover, but that turned into 6 points. They got to make up for that here.
We always hear about empty possessions, but some are worse than others. You can have an empty possession, pump the ball away, get yourself set to play defense, but when you turn it over, it changes momentum, and when they take it downfield and punch it in on you, that's a bad possession.
That's into a crowd and intercepted.
Nice.
And they will take over at the 29-yard
line. I'll take it.
That was just one of those interceptions from our perspective here. We got a good view at the 50-yard line mid-level that quarterback and receiver were not on the same page.
Just by his reaction, I'm talking about the quarterback, he expected something different from his receiver, whether he expected him to break in, out, deeper, short. They'll determine that on the sideline. The bottom line, you can see that he thought he'd be in a different spot, except the defender was not his intended target.
Now a throw in the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete. Marquez Stevenson, the intended target, and that'll bring up second down. Now Brady. Touchdown! Tom Brady with two first-quarter touchdown passes, and the Buccaneers are off to a 13-0 first-quarter lead. There you have it, another challenge and another victory. Now remember, you can always replay challenges if you left any stars on the table. Not even 2 minutes into this football game, already we've had two score.
Hello there, it's the coach with you here today, and this is an ultimate challenge. Taking you the rest of the way, here's Brandon Godden and Charles Davis. Brandon.
Coach, this challenge starts off in the fourth quarter, but there's still a lot of time left on the clock. You're down in this one. You
have That's why Brady to go.
5 yard line, and it's third and 10. An important play right here, third and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
Look at that.
Pass hauled in downfield. And all the way in. Touchdown, New England. Marquez Stevenson. 65 yards. Congratulations on yet another victory. Now you can go right to the next challenge if there's another one available, or return to challenges to receive your reward.
My boy was calling Brady Cook.
Welcome in, everybody. It's the coach with you here today for another edition of Madden Ultimate Team. Let's join this one already in progress. Here's Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Finally, a quick score.
This challenge in the fourth quarter with over 5 minutes left in regulation. You're down two scores. You've got the ball on your side of the field as we get set here, first and 10. And incomplete, he dropped it. Maybe a rookie mistake there. Second down. Fair to say, hasn't been his best game throwing the football, but also not getting a lot of help out there either.
Yeah, you nailed it pretty well, you know. He's got to throw it better, got to get more help. Obviously, one that should have been caught, they got to find a way to bring those two elements together so they can make some progress in this one.
A gain of 28 yards there and give them a first down.
This possession means so much for them. They've got to focus on this drive and find a way to make this a one-possession game. Yes. Got to get a score.
Yeah, so good with a field goal. Don't necessarily need a touchdown. Brady's throw there complete, and they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. That's over 40 yards of movement with those last two plays. Taken in here by Powell. And all the way in. Touchdown, New England. Cornell Powell, 38 yards. And the Patriots have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. And a nice job by him to catch the slant and then navigate and break free.
And receivers love slant routes because it gets the ball in their hands so quickly and oftentimes on the move. And when they're on the move like that, then they get to use their best asset, which is usually their speed.
And their speed sometimes, like this instance, can take them into the end zone. Brady will look to throw for it. And this is caught. They got it. And that could be an important 2 points. It gets him back within a field goal. I guess the coach looked at the 2-point cheat sheet, said go for it, get it to a 3-point game, and they did it.
Yeah, and sometimes you just throw out time of game. You don't worry about that. There's just a feel sometimes in making that call, and he felt good about what he had for a 2-point conversion, and now they're only down 3 and feeling great about themselves.
The kicking unit out for the Patriots as they send this one away. Now Tre'Davious White on the return. Now a hit and a loose football. And it's picked up by the Patriots. And they are going to take over right there at the 22-yard line. So how about this for a turn of events? They cut the lead with a touchdown, and then on the ensuing kickoff, get the football right back.
And what a swing in a short amount of time, because the momentum was totally against them. Now it's all in their favor. They've got a chance to go into the lead if they get the ball to the end zone.
On first and 10, here's Brady. And that, nearly picked off. It would have been a great time for their first interception of the game. Instead, it's second down. So after the incompletion, second and 10 from the 22. To throw is Brady. And that would get a wide up incomplete. Nearly an interception of the end zone, probably should have been. Third down coming up. On play action, now Brady. And that is incomplete.
Has to be a little bit of frustration there. Back-to-back incompletions. Receivers blanketed on both attempts, this time on third down.
Blanket ship's kick is good. And in the fourth quarter, this game is tied. Well, he was a spectator for much of this game. This is his first field goal opportunity of the entire contest, but he's able to connect.
Yeah, he had a pretty good seat to this one, didn't he? But let's face it, all kickers that you and I know, they want to contribute. They want their opportunity.
He's going to come back, y'all.
Nothing separating these two sides. 24 all our score as he sends this one away. Here's White. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. Back now on offense, the Buffalo Bills. And we essentially have a brand new ball game. After that last field goal has tied us all up, we brace for what should be an exciting rest of this fourth quarter. Allen and the Bills now with a first and 10 at their own 26. They throw right away, and that's complete out on the right side. And all the way down to the 29. The thing that hurt on that play, the missed tackle, that allowed the extra yardage.
It's a matchup game in the NFL. You get the guy that you want isolated, have him miss a tackle, and off you go.
And they've got it in the red zone now, down at about the 19. 84 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long. Right back to Singletary on second down. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
That's great.
They'll run on first down with Singletary. This carry.
Yeah, like they can't fly, yeah.
He stops short of the 10. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8. On second down, here's a run with Singletary. The broken tackle could not free him as he's brought down at the 10-yard line. All tied up, less than 2 minutes to go. So it's Bills football here as we get you reset. They've got a third down, but they are in field goal range already. Allen going to give this one to Singletary. There's a nice, and he'll take it into the end zone for a Buffalo touchdown.
Four tackles.
Second touchdown of the afternoon, and the Bills have broken the tie. Well, we have seen the stiff arm get a bit of renaissance here in recent seasons, and that was pure strength there as he forced his way into the end zone.
Four tackles.
You think of guys who use the stiff arm so effectively? I go back to guys like Earl Campbell, Walter Payton, some recent guys like Marshawn Lynch. Let's go to the Wayback Machine. Bronco Nagurski, he dealt out a wicked stiff arm.
New England with a first down as they begin the drive. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them wanted to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted that, that weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants a drive to end with a kick, other than the extra point. That's it.
Yeah, Brady's throw there, incomplete. A couple extra defensive backs out there in the dive, and because of that, really not many places to throw the football, if any.
And typically, what would you want to do against that dime?
Run the football.
You want to run the ball, but you can't do it in this situation. Not nearly enough time on the clock. You have to really navigate against a tough defense presented against you.
Brady to throw. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Patriot touchdown. Des Fitzpatrick, 31 yards. And the Patriots are an extra point away from tying this game here in the final minutes. Well, the hard part's done. Now they just need to split the posts, tie it up, but then their defense is going to have to hold up to send it to overtime.
Yeah, no matter what. I know there's an inclination in it when you have momentum to go for two here, but if you miss it, you don't give your defense a chance at all.
Plus, it's been a good game. I want to see overtime. I'm selfish.
You obviously don't have a flight to catch.
Tomorrow. Don't forget the extra point. It's up and good. We are tied here in the fourth quarter. So that drive, 4 plays. And it's finished off by a pass touchdown. So here comes the kickoff now. All even here in this fourth quarter. On the return, here's White. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25. Bills come to the line to start their next drive. They've got work to do, but they do still have a bit of time here.
And they've got to feel comfortable with that, but they have all their play sequences called. If they get out of bounds, that allows them to huddle and call another play, but if they don't, let's hurry up to the line of scrimmage and either spike it and stop the clock or continue to move it downfield in order to try and get in range and win this game.
See if they can do just that. Here's Allen. He lost the football, and the Patriots have it.
Is it me, or do they fall really retarded when they get the fumble? Or the whistle is dead. The whistle is blown. Like, I really don't get it, yo. I never did get that concept. I think that That shit is retardedly stupid.
Sure they take care of the ball now. They've got a chance to put this thing away.
Now flags come in. Looked like one of the Patriots might have moved. Now they nab the rookie there for the 5-yard penalty.
So much going through his head. You know it just has to be, right? All of his assignments and realizing every game he plays, one of the better players in the league will be opposite him.
The full start backs him up 5, first and 15. The throw by Brady, knocked away, incomplete. Tre'Davious White, the LSU man, there to knock it away that time.
As a defensive back, you have some weapons at your disposal that we don't often talk about, and you can read the receiver's eyes, you can read his hands, and you know that the arrival of the ball is imminent, and that allows you to make a play on it and oftentimes knock it away.
He'll wind up getting 4 there on his own, but it will leave him now with a third down.
God
situation.
Damn, he's slow as a turtle.
Will use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 37 seconds to play.
Yo, slow as a turtle.
This great starting field position, a real threat. This is third and long. Mason. It's still fighting.
What the fuck are you doing?
Before going out, they're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Boy, missed tackles. That could be their downfall, Charles.
Yeah, they actually let him out of bounds there. Instead of the clock continuing to run, they let him out, and it turned into another timeout for him.
Oh, you fired.
Field goal would be a chip shot from here. Let's see how they play it on first and goal. Now they run. It's Mason. They'll get this halfway home from the 8 to the 4 on a gain of 4.
At this stage, you've got to hustle. Got to get back to the line of scrimmage because you're saving that timeout to make sure you have a chance to get your kicker out there for the big shot.
Now the timeout will be called, so they're in field goal range with 3 seconds left.
That's a game.
His kick is good. And with that, they will move out in front by 3. Done. You've defeated this ultimate challenge. Now, if there are stars still available, you can always replay the challenge again. Otherwise, it's time to move on to the next one.
Hello, everyone. You're watching Ultimate Challenges, and I'm your host, the coach. To finish this out, here's Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
For this challenge, we are in the fourth quarter with just a little over a minute left on the clock. You're trailing by 4. You have possession on your own 30-yard line, and it's first and 10. To throw is Brady. That's into the hands of Fitzpatrick. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. A very solid gain of 27.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner, to watch them drive for what would be a goal.
Oh, shit.
And you and I both know this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there, not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team.
It's for the game. Oh! That was nice. Yo, Boston.
I know it's a never-say-never situation, but to me, like that's the one that's going to finish him off.
That was nice. I'm digging it. Oh, Lord, I got one to come back again.
We need is a big return.
And what happened?
What's the deal with the comebacks and shit? I don't get it. But okay.
Hey, folks, it's the coach here. Welcome back for another exciting matchup in Madden Ultimate Team. Now let's hand it off to Brandon and Charles as we jump straight.
Oh, with the last round.
This challenge begins in the fourth quarter with less than 2 minutes to go in the ball game. You're behind. You've got possession in your own territory. First and 10.
Oh, he's gone.
Stevenson. And all the way in. Touchdown, New England. Marquez Stevenson. 56 yards. And the Patriots have moved out in front here in the fourth quarter. Yeah. We know it all too well. You give Tom Brady time on the clock in the fourth quarter, you're playing with fire. We just saw it.
Yeah, and when you talk about playing with fire, it's really more like a raging inferno when it's Tom Brady, isn't it? And you almost expect it. Actually, you know he's going to come downfield and score against you. But here's the thing. Can you match Tom Brady now? Because there's still time on the clock for a chance to come back at
him. Gosh. Good catch, baby.
Because you're right, there's still quite a bit of time. So they make the decision. They want a three-point lead versus a two-point lead, and they got it.
Yeah, at this stage of the game, it seems like the exact right thing to do. Put a little pressure on your defense, but the biggest thing now is you're making the other team chase you.
Oh, the return. It's Tariq Cohen. Now a crease here as he's past the 30. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. Dalton and the offense now. Down by a field goal, a minute 35 to go. And they need 3 points out of this as they come up first and 10. Now Dalton. And this one is incomplete. Darnell.
Andy Dalton, the dude from the Bengals, yo. That was my mess up.
And all the way down to the
12. I should have did that.
And we've reached the 1 minute mark in this game. And he can't get a throw off.
The sack.
Taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Here's Dalton. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far and brings up third down. Big spot, Andy Dalton. And he finds his target. It's Marquise Goodwin. Just a 5-yard pickup, and it leads to fourth down.
That was game.
First things first here, they got to pick up the first down.
And remember, it is fourth down, so they've got to pick up a completion here. Otherwise, this one's over.
Miss.
Breaking finish. And that's just gonna do it for us in this one. You've notched another win, and the next challenge awaits.
I gotta score 3 touchdowns by the end of the game. Are you serious, yeah? Yo, Brady situation is trash, yo. Let me see what I'm looking at, yeah. Just to get his token there.
Salute when you sink. That jealousy, there's an ocean, and you either float or you sink. Roll control, credit check. You not approved. BB King, I'm in love with the blues. Don't start me up, I got finishing moves. Look. Salute when you sink. Slid through all the commotion, it's breaking news, they got an ad on TV. Popping out all of my politics, I'm probably in a section where you never live. My honey's matching my Dodger, feeling playing all gold, ain't no stopping in it. Look, salute when you see me, I bought her a CC and that was her purse. Disgusting with, do for a purse, disgusting with, do for the clout. I'm one of the real ones could vouch, they thought I was done, but all I did out, you gotta pay my next round. Salute when you see me. Put in the car to the, my runner gets me speed. Made it out of the trenches. Yeah, salute when you see me. Yeah, salute when you see me. I'm getting greedy. I blow to her budget on me. That's on me. I'm conceited. Treaty. Nah, that ain't how we treat it. This right here sound like a three-peat.
Okay. So my content, I get a Power Up Fantasy Pack exclusive early access Power Up Art. An Elite 80 Plus Wide Receiver Pack and 1,500 coins. I bet. That'll work. It's annoying, but it'll work.
you to love me, I want you to need me.
Hello, and welcome into this Madden Ultimate Team Showdown. I'm your host, the coach. Listen to that.
I'll be back.
For the call.
I'm back, y'all.
Ready for football.
I got to score all passing touchdowns.
Ultimate team from the six. And he takes this 25. Just a little pass there. Call it the.
Let's see what the goals are. Win the game. The hang on hunt. In the first half. Are you serious? I got to go hang on hunt in the first half. And I got to get three touchdowns. Pass and touchdown. Yeah. All of this, yeah? Really? All right. Go make his work, yeah. So that means I gotta cook. I'm gonna try to cook real quick.
They fake the handoff. Now Brady. Over the middle, complete. It's Powell. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. That goes for a gain of 31. Play action. Now it's Brady. Completes it to Powell. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop it. Into the red zone. It's Brady. Back-to-back plays of that. He's got it. Caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay.
Cool.
Three plays already in the end zone. That was quick.
We always talk about offenses understanding what they want to do before they go into a game, and they practice it. They have their script and the plays they want to open with. But defenses aren't just reactive. They have their own ideas as well. These ideas didn't get implemented very well.
I got to win the game. Already scored against. I got to score three touchdowns. That is crazy. You know how crazy that is, man?
Take it in at the goal line. Now a hit. Woo! Loose football. And the Buccaneers have it.
As that ball got away from him and he saw the opposing team recover it,
he felt his pain.
Smacked the shit out of him.
Tuck it away. Take care of the ball. All the things he hears all week in practice, he didn't carry it over into the game.
I smacked the shit out of him, man.
So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. Here's Brady. And it's caught. And in for the Buccaneers touchdown. Tom Brady with two first quarter touchdown passes. And the Bucs have taken a 13-0 first quarter lead.
Partner, remember that old film of Peyton Manning going through the route tree with his great receivers in Indianapolis? I think we're seeing the results of the same type of work here today. These guys know each other so well that they don't even have to call the play. They can just look each other and know the route that's going to be run, and usually the connection is perfect.
Extra point by Blankenship is up and good, and it's now 14 to nothing. The Bucs ready for the kickoff, and here we go. It's in the air. Taken at the goal line. And all deep in his own territory, he coughs up the football. We got our first look now at Aaron Rodgers in his 17th season now with the Green Bay Packers, and of course coming off a great 2020. Where he took home the MVP trophy.
There have been very few quarterbacks in the NFL who have been as consistent throughout their career as Aaron Rodgers. He's been good for so long, and we've seen no decline in his skills. His accuracy and arm strength continue to elevate the talent around him, and his in-game mistakes, few and far between.
Rodgers now on first down. Looking for Funchess, but it's intercepted. Picked up by Ifeatu Melifonwu. And they'll take possession already in the red zone and in a great spot to add points to the scoreboard.
And Brandon, how many times have we seen a defense with a lot of field behind them get even more aggressive, right? They played that gap, not pinned down, but in a favorable spot for them. And they took advantage of it there, got a nice interception, and set up their offense in great shape.
A gain of 9 there, sets up second and goal. Now Brady. And he hauls it in for the Buccaneer touchdown. Marquez Stevenson there to make the grab. All right, you did it. You got the win. Congratulations. Keep that momentum going and tackle that next challenge as his guys have opened up a very comfortable lead.
There's on these. Would they have a fetish for 3 touchdowns or some shit? I don't get it.
Everybody, I'm the coach. Up next, another ultimate challenge on EA.
Another feat for Tom Brady. That's scored 3 touchdowns. This is ridiculous.
And off we go from Tampa. Tyreek Hill on the return. And look at this. Right away, a loose football. And it's picked up by the Buccaneers. And his guys are going to take over at the 21-yard line. Well, it's hard enough to play on the road in this league as it is. But to start on the road with a fumble on the opening kickoff, just not the precedent you obviously want to set.
Not at all. And now it's just words because they've talked about it all week. From the time they start game planning for this one, remember, going into hostile territory, we have to set the tone right in the beginning, and they do the exact opposite.
Now, here's a look for the end zone, but that one's going to wind up incomplete. From the 21, it's 2nd and 10. Brady going to throw. And that nearly an interception here on this opening drive, but he gets a reprieve. It's 3rd down. They don't want to waste his outstanding field position on this opening drive as they come up on 3rd down. He's got Mason complete. Touchdown!
That'll work. I'll take it.
And remember the good old days when the 49ers were riding roughshod in the league? They use their fullback and pass plays all the time. Roger Craig, Tom Rathman, those guys were terrific at running these types of plays.
Set to return it. And out a little across the 25 to the 27. Go. Rams will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 at their own 27. Powering his way forward. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. Nice way to start the drive, a gain of 12 and a first down. On the carry, Thompson. And they'll get to him after a gain of 7 to the 47. Well, you often say that sort of opens the playbook now, second and short. What do you think, early shot here?
I like where you're going. Obviously, we've been together for a while because you know me. I want to take that shot early and loosen things up.
And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30.
Let's go.
Clyde Edwards-Helaire is a do-it-all back, and he did plenty on that run. And as a rookie, 803 yards rushing for the season in Kansas City, may look to up his workload a little bit in year two. The last pick of the first round in 2020, he more than justified that selection with his ability to run the football and catch it out of the backfield.
But now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. Travis Kelce, the Pro Bowl tight end, the intended target. But it'll be second down, and only able to muster a couple, down to about the 27. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a third and 8 coming up. Mahomes gonna throw. And that is intercepted.
Good.
He did not keep the feet in bounds, apparently. So
damn.
This is going to be an incompletion. Butker's kick here is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So, yes, it's only 3, but at least they're able to answer back after giving up the touchdown to start the game.
Yeah, I like the observation there because getting some points on the board, very positive for them. Feel a little bit better about things because if you don't score, you potentially have opened the door for them to score again, and then you're down 14.
Here we go. Here we go. Here we go.
The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. They had the touchdown on the opening drive of the ball game. It was countered by just a field goal. So, hey, if your guys can do that for four quarters, you're in good shape.
Yeah, it is a team game. So
oh, he scores a bitch, yeah.
But, you know, I know I'm no brainiac, but you trade sixes for threes, things are going to work out in your favor.
After one, 7-3 the score on EA Sports. Now a throw complete to his fullback out of the backfield. Bulldozes past him. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. The two big plays right in succession as this one goes for 27. Brady now on first down. And the coverage terrific there as that's knocked down and incomplete. Legarius right there to knock it away. On play action, it's Brady. And he's got it. Caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Trey McKinney there to make the grab as the Buccaneers tack on to their lead.
That's a beautiful ball right there as he waited for his tight end to come uncovered in the end zone, so give him points for patience as well. Delivered it right where it needed to be for 6 points.
Rodrigo Blankenship on for the PAT. And this one's right through to make it a 14-3 ball game. A drive there of just 4 plays. And it's all finished off with a touchdown by Tampa Bay. The Bucs ready for the kickoff. And here we go. It's in the air. Here's the dangerous Tyreek Hill.
Damn.
Ended up just past the 20 as his guys will go to work at the 21-yard line. Kansas City taking the field for their second drive. And tough to win games if you're going field goal, field goal, field goal here. They got field goal last time. Now they'll be looking for a touchdown.
They're looking for the big chunk now because, as you noted, the field goal, field goal, field goal way of doing it makes it that much harder and puts more pressure on every possession for you now. Go ahead and get six and feel a lot more comfortable about the position they're in.
Bigger chunks. We'll see if they can get the score. We've got a 14-3 ball game with 2 minutes left in the opening half. Call that a very strong gain of 24. A reminder, coming up at halftime, Jonathan Coachman will join us from Orlando with our halftime report. But business to take care of before we get there.
A two-minute drill before the coaches' two-minute drill.
It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And it'll be second and very short.
Oh, here's a bum. He fired. He fired.
But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
They go play fake. Mahomes. And he drops this off to Thompson, complete. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. The Chiefs have got the passing game rolling a bit, and another first down.
Yeah, these are the types of plays they're going to need to hit on if they're going to get back into this game. It hasn't been the greatest of first halves, but this is a nice throw here on third down, and they keep the drive going.
Mahomes firing complete. A good rally to the football keeps him to only a yard, and it's second down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Looking to throw again on second down. Mahomes. And he's going to be pressure gets there back at the 39-yard line. The Chiefs now going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw.
Damn.
To
oh, he dropped it.
This to the 31, but that is still that'll work. Short of what he needed. It'll be a gain of 8, but it also lead to a fourth down. Distance.
And he nearly had that too, but it was a crossbar that said otherwise, and that'll deny him a shot at 3.
And Brady's throw there incomplete. He was looking for Cornell Powell there. That'll bring up second down. And unless this is a quick incompletion, this is likely the last play here of this first half. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. And just like that, on we head to half number 2. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number 3. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. Out come the Buccaneers. They'll have it first to start the third quarter. And Charles, you'd have to think this is where you want to start taking some time off the clock.
Oh, definitely, because you got the lead, right? You take a good look up there and you say, okay, what do we need to do here? Well, you're not in full-out protect mode. You want to make sure you run it, throw it safe, take some time off, and eat it up.
Now a throw right side taken in here to start this drive. And they're able to get this one across the 35. He was held without a catch in the first half, but he's got one here, and he also picks up a first down.
And now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a 2-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into.
Slow, yo. Slow.
And finish this one off.
Trash, yo.
Meanwhile, the throw by Brady knocked away, incomplete. Brady's throw there complete. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. Just his second catch of the game so far. This one moves the chains. Brady now on first down. And it's nearly an interception, but it's incomplete. Well, a turnover really would have helped him there, but not to be. The second and 10 now as we roll along in the third quarter from Tampa. And he'll take it across the 50 and into Chief territory. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a 3rd and 8 coming up. On play action, now Brady. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
Fucking bum, yo.
That was a nice job defensively of disguising their coverage and making it difficult for the quarterback to lock in on a receiver. And it results in an incomplete pass.
Brady to throw for it on 4th down. He's going to fire one deep, middle of the field. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. The Bucs try it on 4th down, but come up empty. And this defense will take over right near midfield at the 49-yard line. First play of the drive is a run with Thompson. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it 2nd down. A shotgun snap, and a give to Edwards-Helaire. And oh, he's going to be brought down by the face mask. Here come the flags. This is going to get him a 1st down. Well, you hate that defensively. They had him pretty well corralled, but the face mask, that obviously changes things.
Yeah, it's a bit frustrating because you feel like you did everything right. You had him stop, but the hand gets up just a little too high, and the natural inclination is to hold on, and that's going to get called every time.
Throwing on 1st down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. He was trying to get that to Edwards-Helaire out of the backfield, and now it's 2nd down. Throwing now is Mahomes. Mahomes hit. He lost the football. But it looks like the Chiefs are going to get it back. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. You are watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. Back now in Tampa. So danger averted for the moment, but now here's a 3rd and long. It's the Chiefs with a football, but with work to do on the scoreboard, they trail as we start quarter number 4. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football, and it's picked up by the Buccaneers.
Brandon, I don't want to violate any of our broadcasting rules by declaring a game over before it's over, but that one, that puts them in real jeopardy there.
Absolutely. It was a 2-possession game. It is a 2-possession game at this stage in the 4th. They needed points out of that drive.
And obviously now, no chance at all to get those points that they so desperately needed.
Touchdown, Tampa Bay! Cornell Powell, 45 yards. And the Bucs have pretty well put it away here in the 4th quarter. They were still throwing with a comfortable lead.
Is a bad blood that went into this one ahead of time, that maybe they're seeking some revenge or they just don't like them. But the other thing that always hits me is, are they worried about playoff positioning? Right? Are they worried about, do you need enough points in case there's a tiebreaker that comes into play later?
Extra point by Blankenship is up and good. And the lead is up to 18 now. Those are the kind of drives they like.
What's the other goal? Oh, and I got one again. Damn.
From the coordinator to the quarterback, the line, everybody. 1-play drive and into the end zone for 6. The Bucs ready for the kickoff. And here we go. It's in the air. Returning it, Hill. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line. The Chiefs' offense about set to begin this drive. And they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go-around.
A big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over. The other team takes it down and scores. That can be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
Well, they're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up. And they'll try to squeeze in one more play here before the two-minute warning. From the 31, Mahomes. And he'll get this into the hands of Hill, complete. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. So the Chiefs in possession of the ball.